Why does coding sometimes feel boring, frustrating, and even anxiety-inducing? Sometimes you are just sitting there staring at a screen and it feels like you're making no progress. And honestly, coding is the opposite to the instant dopamine hits we get from social media, movies, or video games. It's something that requires patience, focus, and repetition. But coding is also the skill that has transformed my life. It landed me my first job, and from there has opened so many doors. It has afforded me this freedom to travel the world and work solo. I've been coding for over 8 years now, and let me tell you, I wouldn't have been able to stick with it for this long if it felt like a constant grind. Over time, I found ways to make coding enjoyable and something I genuinely look forward to doing. So in this video, I'll share some tricks to make every coding session feel rewarding, not stressful. And I'll give you some simple ways to gamify the process and build an environment that gets you coding consistently. Video games are known for being extremely addictive. They tap into core elements like progression and rewards to keep players engaged. So let's borrow these same principles to make coding just as enjoyable. Progression. Break down your goals into small, achievable milestones. This shortens the feedback loop, allowing you to regularly check off milestones, giving you a clear sense of progression. As you complete each milestone, it keeps you motivated to tackle the next one. I also use my GitHub contributions chart as a way to visualize my streaks and overall consistency. Once I get a streak going, I'm motivated to keep it alive. There have been many times where I didn't feel like coding, but the fact I wanted to keep my streak alive forced me to write some code and push some commits. And often, these initial commits lead to longer, productive coding sessions. Reward. After a long and productive coding session, you should reward yourself for the hard work you've put in. Treat yourself to something you enjoy, eat your favorite meal, binge some YouTube, or spend some time with friends. Not only is this enjoyable, it trains your brain to associate coding with positive emotions. And over time, your brain will want to code out of habit, even when there is no reward lined up, simply because it remembers the satisfaction associated with it. An effective resource that makes learning to code fun and engaging is Scrimba. Scrimba is a platform with interactive courses on everything from front-end to full-stack development. The unique Scrims technology truly makes learning to code an enjoyable experience. It lets you run and preview your code in real time directly in the browser. Along with that, one of the things that sets Scrimba apart from other platforms is the ability to code along with the teacher. This lets you practice and apply what you've learned by doing, not just watching. And you can rewind or fast forward anywhere in the tutorial to correct your mistakes and learn at your own pace. And what I really love about Scrimba is their focus on project-based learning. They provide useful code templates to help you build and ship projects faster. For example, they have code snippets to help you create a simple AI chat app or your own portfolio website to showcase your work. And here's the best part. Scrimba's content is regularly updated, so you can be confident in staying up to date with the latest technologies and trends. If you couldn't tell, I'm super excited and grateful to be working with Scrimba. Check them out, first link in the description. All of my most enjoyable coding sessions happen when I enter flow state. Everything just clicks, writing code feels effortless, and time flies by. By the end of the session, I feel accomplished and I cannot wait to go again. This is one of the reasons that makes coding so addictive. Once you are able to tap into the flow state, it's like experiencing a high unlike anything else. Here are some ways that reliably gets me into flow state and, more importantly, stay there. The first step is to create an optimized workspace. It goes without saying, if you are trying to do deep work but not eliminating distractions, you are self-sabotaging your productivity. Turn off notifications, silence your phone, and close any extra tabs. I like to keep my desk minimal, so that's just my laptop, a coffee, and nothing more. I also prefer working in libraries, study cafes, or co-working spaces. Aside from the fact that these places are built for focus and work, I found that being surrounded by others who are focused and locked in motivates me to do the same. It gives an unspoken sense of accountability. Our brains need to be primed before a deep work session and be given closure at the end of one. As a quick warm-up, review yesterday's commits to refresh what you did the day before. Then, go over today's to-dos to set a clear goal for the session. And before logging off, brain dump tomorrow's tasks and any blockers into a text file or journal. This helps clear your mind and primes you for a strong start the next day, as you'll know exactly where to pick things up. Working in short, intense bursts help you get the most done in the least amount of time. In order to do this, you must focus on accomplishing only one thing at a time. Trying to multitask will scatter your attention. You don't need a rigid Pomodoro timer routine, but when you sit down to code, commit to a singular task. and I usually keep going until I've completed the task or at least made some progress on it. But when you feel like your focus is starting to fade, take a break and let your mind wander. Sometimes, stepping away from a stubborn problem leads to those aha moments as your brain works in the background. Adopting the right mindset can transform coding from being a grind into something genuinely fun. Let's explore some mindset shifts that made a big difference for me. When you encounter bugs and new challenges, it's easy to view them as roadblocks. Instead, shift your perspective to see them as opportunities to grow and innovate. The solution you're looking for likely exists, you just haven't found it yet. Prioritize progress over perfection. If you've already made the big decisions of choosing your app idea and which tech stack you will use, then you don't need to waste time obsessing over minor technical details or trying to over-engineer the most optimal solution. When it comes to coding, you make the most progress and have the most fun by doing it. Besides, coding by nature is iterative. Every app needs to be debugged, refactored, and optimized at some point. Test your code, ship it, and update it if needed. And as a reminder, coding can be a lonely and challenging activity. And you should acknowledge that what you're doing is hard. Tackling complex problems and building something from nothing is not easy. If it was, everyone would do it and it would have no value. Lastly, let's discuss something many of us who spend a lot of time online could benefit from: a dopamine detox. Now, before you roll your eyes from hearing this buzzword yet again, hear me out. We all know overstimulation from social media, video games, and binge watching floods our brains with dopamine. And sadly, this makes things that require effort and focus, like coding, feel slow and dull in comparison. Try limiting screen time to 30 minutes to an hour a day. Put distracting devices in different rooms or switch them off completely. Put your phone on grayscale and replace doom scrolling with a workout, walk, or book. You'll find yourself experiencing less brain fog, better focus, and higher productivity. And over time, hard activities like coding will become enjoyable again. For more solo startup content, please like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.